Welcome to today class of nonlinear vibration. So today class will start the module 5, where we'll discuss about the nonlinear techniques used for analysis of vibration, nonlinear vibration systems. So in this module, so basically we'll discuss three things: one, time modulation, how to find the time response of the system, how to find the frequency response of the system, and the basin of attraction of the system. So, in time response, to find the time response of the system, let us take one example. So, and how we are proceed to solve this nonlinear systems, we will discuss, and then different numerical techniques used in these systems also we are going to discuss. So, let us take this system. So, in which, so we have a slender cantilever beam with one tip mass, and the base is excited and the base is moving up and down. Already we know how to derive the equation motion of the system. The point of discussion in this case is how we can numerically determine the system parameters, and then what other numerical techniques we are going to use in this case to solve or to find the response of the system. So, particularly today we will discuss about this time response of the system, how to characterize those time response. So, in case of time response, to characterize those time response, we may use this Poincar section, we may use this spectra, or we may go for this Lyapunov exponent. So, today class will discuss about how to determine this coefficient of the governing equation, then how to determine the time response, and after getting the time response, how to characterize them by using this Poincar section and the Lyapunov exponent. So, in this case, to derive this equation, briefly let us discuss, to derive this equation of the system, so we can write the potential energy of the system. So, the potential energy of the system can be written in this way, and to make the system nonlinear by assuming moderately large deflection of the system, moderately large transverse deflection of the system, we can write this curvature equal to 1 by r equal to del square w by del y square into 1 by 1 plus tan square alpha to the power 3 by 2, where we can have this alpha is this angle. So, we can write this equation. So, we can write this tan alpha equal to minus del w by del y, and substituting this equation in this equation. So, where, so this is the a small portion of the curve is shown here. So, this angle shows this is alpha and this is d alpha, and from this one can find detailed study of this will give you the equation motion, or we can write the potential energy using this equation, where w is the transverse deflection, y is the coordinate in y direction. So, and then we can have, we can write this E equal to Young's modulus, I is the moment of inertia of the system, and one can write the potential energy of the system using this equation. Now, one can note that this equation contain not only the term, this term which is particularly useful for the linear system, but also contain these additional terms. So, these additional terms will make the system nonlinear. So, now one can find the energy of the link due to compressive force. So, as a force is applied to the system, so due to considering a compressive force, so one can write the potential energy of the system or energy of the system using this equation. Then the potential energy of the system, total potential energy will be U 1 plus U 2, and the kinetic energy of the system can be written in this way. So, now using extended Hamilton principle, so one can find the equation motion. The purpose of today lecture is not to derive this equation motion, but to see how we can obtain the coefficient of these equations and how we can obtain the time response of the system when will be given a equation motion. So, for example, in this case the equation motion in spatio-temporal form is given by this equation 10. So, After getting this equation, now we have to convert this spatio-temporal equation to its temporal form. So, temporal forms by applying this Galerkin method. So, to apply Galerkin method, we should consider one, we should find the eigenfunction or one shape functions of the system and the time modulation. So, in this case, this is the equation and the corresponding boundary conditions are given by this. So, these are the corresponding boundary conditions. And now, to solve this equation, we have taken this w x y, w y t equal to r psi y and g t, where r is the scaling factor, psi is the shape function and g t is the time modulation. And psi y, one can take the psi y as the shape functions of or the eigenfunction of either a cantilever beam or a cantilever beam with tip mass. Here it is taken as that of a system with tip mass. So, this is the psi y and one can obtain this characteristic constant beta by solving this equation. So, by solving this equation, one can obtain the characteristic constant beta, and by using this equation 12 and 13, so one can, and applying this Galerkin method, so one can find the temporal equation. So, this is the temporal equation. Now, the purpose is to find how we can find these coefficient phi square, here phi, and then alpha 10, then zeta, alpha 20, alpha 30, and how to solve this equation to obtain the solution of the system. So, to obtain this equation, now first one has to find this beta l. How to find this beta l? So, to find this beta l, one has to solve this characteristic equation. So, there are several methods to find the solution of the characteristic equation. So, some of the solution methods, before going for the solution method, let us see what are the other coefficients. So, here to obtain these coefficients, one has to integrate these things to find, for example, h 1 equal to integration of psi square, h 2 equal to psi into psi 4 dash, and similarly h 3, h 4, h 5 and many other coefficients one may get if one take the system to be more and more nonlinear. So, here the fast mode frequency can be written in this term, in this equation, E I z by m l fourth into h 2 by h 1. So, to obtain the coefficient, one has to integrate these shape functions. Also, to find the shape functions, one has to solve the characteristic equation. So, as the characteristic equation is not simple and this is a transcendental equation, so one has to solve this equation numerically to find the value of beta l. So, to solve this equation numerically, so one has to go for this numerical technique. And now, after getting this equation, getting this temporal equation, one has to solve this equation either qualitatively or quantitatively. One can also solve this equation by using different numerical techniques to find the response for the given system parameters, or one can use this perturbation method to find the equation, to find the reduced equation, which are then solved to obtain the solution. Now, let us go step by step. So, first we have to find the solution of the characteristic equation. To find the solution of the characteristic equation, so either one can use this interval halving or method of bisection, or false position or regular falsi method, or one can go for this Newton's method. One may use the second method, one may use this Muller method. So, let us consider these methods in detail. So, how one can use this method of bisection? So, we have given a function f x equal to 0. So, we have to solve this equation numerically to find the solution. So, for example, while solving this equation, so one can use two different approaches. First, one can take this bracketing method. So, one can take this bracketing or and then refining. So first one has to bracket the roots. So one first has to find roots, where the roots lie. So to bracket this root, one can use many different type of methods. One such method is the brute force method, in which one can take a course. Let we want to find, let we assume that the solution lies between 0 and 5, then taking this interval 0 to 1 to 5. So, we can find, we can check whether the solution lies in between or in some range. Then if we find that thing, then we can we found that it is lying between 2 and 3, then we can use the refined value. So, now we will increment this thing with a very small value, let for example 0.00123. So, initially to bracket this thing we will use a coarse increment, for example, here in this case we have taken an increment of 1, or we may take for this coarse case we may take it is equal to 0.5. So, we can increase this thing from 0 to 5 with increment of 0.5, and we can check whether the solution lies in that range. So, after bracketing this thing, then to find the actual solution or to find the accurate solution, we can refine the range. So, we can refine this range with a very precision increment. So, for example, we can take an increment of 0.001 in this case. So, in case of this interval hopping or method of bisection, so let us discuss what is method of bisection. So, in case of method of bisection, so let this is the function. So, this function f x, after we have bracketed it, so we know it lies between a and b. So, let it lies with, so this is x coordinate, this is f x. So, we know that this f a is negative and f b is positive. So, the solution lie between this f region a and b, or the solution lie within a and b. So, after you know this thing, now the next step to find will be, so let us take a point c. So, in case of method of bisection, we will take a point c such that c will be equal to a plus b by 2. So, we will take this point c equal to a plus b by 2, and now let this is the point c. So, let this is the point c. Now, what we observe? So, we can find this f c. So, we can see that f c is positive. Now, then we will take the point between a and c, and then we can find this c dash, or next step we can find this again the c point we can find by taking the c dash will be equal to a plus c by 2. So, we will take another point, let c dash is this. So, this is c dash, or let me take this is d, instead of taking c dash I can take this point d. So, this is point d. Now, the solution will lie between d and c. So, we will repeat this iteration by taking these points at the average value of the previously determined points, and in that way we can finally obtain the solution x 0. So, this is the solution x 0 which we required. So, in case of method of bisection, first we have to bracket by finding two points in which one will yield a positive value and other will have a negative value. So, after getting these two points, the next point we can, or the solution we can tell that the solution will be approached if you take a point which is half of this point a and b. So, we will take c equal to a plus b by 2, then we will check the value of f x. So, we will repeat this iteration till we have achieved a accuracy, or we have achieved this thing. So, if we can, let finally we got this x 0. So, in this case we have to find this x 0 minus the previous value, let it is x I. So, this mod should be less than epsilon, epsilon, so here epsilon is a very small number. So, or this is a precision number 10, we can take this number to be 10 to the power minus 6 or very small number. So, then we can tell that this point converges. So, in this way we can use this method of bisection to find the characteristic root of this equation. One can use the another method, that is the false position method. So, in case of false position method, false position or regular falsi, so in this case we can assume, so let us take the same problem, this is our f x and x. So, let us take, so this is the function. So, we will take initially, we will take two position. So, this is position A, this is B. So, which yield this positive and negative value. So, the next point we can assume by taking, or we can assume that we will fit a linear curve between A and B. So, let us join this A and B. So, by a linear line or straight line, so by joining this curve or approximating this thing by another function g x, where we can get this g x by taking this point A and B, or joining this point A and B by a straight line. So, we can get this g x from this equation. So, then we can obtain this point C. So, our f c, now this f c minus f b by c minus b. So, this is equal to our g dash x. So, we can find the slope of this thing, where f c equal to 0. So, this point as it is intersecting this 0 line, so f c equal to 0. So, from this we can obtain this g dash x. So, now g dash x will be equal to f b minus f a by b minus a, then so we can find the point c for which it will be 0 from this equation. So, c will be equal to b minus f b by g dash x. So, in case of this regular falsi or false position method. So, we are initially taking two points A and B, for which we are getting this f x value positive and negative. The next point we can find by using this equation, that is C equal to B minus f B by g dash x, where this g dash, that is the slope, we can obtain by using this formula, that is f B minus f B. F b minus f a by b minus a. So, we will continue this iteration till we get this b minus a is very very small, that less than epsilon, and this f c value is less than epsilon, that is very very closer to 0. So, when you are considering to find the solution of this f x, that means we are finding this value of x for which this f x equal to 0. So, in that case we can use this false position method. So, in this false position method we have to find this point C. So, this point C we can obtain by using this method, that is C equal to b minus f b by g dash x, and where g dash equal to f b minus f a by b minus a. Also, we can use this Newton's method. So, this is a versatile method to find the solution of this equation. So, in case of Newton's method, so let us take, so this is our equation, that is f x. So, let us plot f x versus x. So, this is our equation fx. Now to find, so first we have bracketed this point, or so here we have to use, so here we need not have to bracket this thing, but we can take a initial point A and the next point we can find by finding, let us take a point here. So now find the, find a tangent to this at this point, draw a tangent to this. So the next point, so if this is the ith point, let this is the ith point x I, the next point x I plus 1, so this point will be x I plus 1, and we can find, which you can see is much closer to the solution point. So this is the solution point, so this is much closer to the solution point. So initially, in case of Newton's method, initially we just take a point x I, this is the initial point, and the next point we can find, that is x I plus 1. So we can find this x I plus 1 equal to x I minus f x I by f dash x I. So this thing we can obtain, so this equation is true, because we can write this f dash x I, it can be defined as, this is slope of x I, so this is equal to f x I plus 1 minus f x I by x I plus 1 minus x I. But as we are assuming this f x I plus 1 equal to 0, so as this is equal to 0, so where the slope cuts this line, the tangent line cuts this x axis, so as f x I plus 1 equal to 0, so we can find this x I plus 1 from this equation. So x I plus 1 will be equal to x I minus f x I by f dash x I. So in this way we can find the next point, which is closer to this. And now after finding this point, next let us find, so how to do it. So we got this point, so at this point let us again draw one more tangent. So one can see, so this is the I x I plus 2, so we have started with x I. Now we have plotted one tangent here, so it cuts this x axis at this x I plus 1. So this x I plus 1 we obtained by using this expression. Now at this x I plus 1 again, let us take this point, that is f, so this is our f x I plus 1. So now at this point, let us again draw one more tangent. So this is intersecting this x axis at x I plus 2. So this x I plus 2 one can obtain by substituting this I equal to I plus 1. So this x I plus 2, for example, in this case will be equal to x I plus 1 minus f x I plus 1 by f dash x I plus 1. So here we can find what is this f x I plus 1. So this is f x I plus 1 and the slope. So we can find the slope by using this, again this equation. So in this way we can go on finding the solution till we obtain the convergence. So we can get the convergence by using the previous method, by, or we can find this convergence from this. So let us find, let x n is the converged solution. So then x n minus x n minus 1 mod of this thing should be very less than epsilon, and this functional value, also this functional value f x n should be very closer to the solution. So it should be very closer to epsilon 2. So here I have written this is epsilon 1. So I can take this value, this epsilon 1 and epsilon 2 of the order of 10 to the power minus 6 or less than this to find one accurate solution. So one can either use this method of bisection, method of false position, Newton's method, or one may use the second method also. So in case of second method, so one can use So, instead of using the straight line, so one can use a quadratic polynomial here. So we can use a secant here, that is, let us use the secant method, and then we will go for the Muller method. So, in case of the secant method, so we can use a secant. So, a secant to a curve is the straight line which passes through two points on the curve. So, we have this is the curve. So, now let us take two points on this. So, if you take two points on this and draw a line, so let this is our f x. Now, we will take two points on this and draw a line. So, this line is passing through this point and this point. So, we can approximate the solution by using this equation, that is our g dash x equal to f x I minus f x I minus 1 by x I minus x I minus 1. So, we have taken this point. So, this first point, that is this one. So, this is x I minus 1. So, this is x I. So, this is our x I, this is x I minus 1. Now, our objective is to find this point. So, this is x I plus 1. So, on this curve we have taken two points, that is x I and x I minus 1. So, these two points can be joined by a straight line. So, that is the second. So, we have joined this by a straight line, and where it is intersecting this x axis, this is x axis and this is our f x. So, it is intersecting at this point, that is our x I plus. So, this will be x I plus 1. So, but actually we have to find this point. So, this is the solution. So, to find this point, so we have started with x I minus 1, x I, two points we have taken. Then we have made a straight line which is intersecting this x axis at I plus 1. So, our objective is to find this I plus 1. So, to find that thing, so we can proceed this way. So, let us first find. So, we have approximated this by this line g x with these two points. Then this g dash x slope of that straight line can be obtained from this equation, that is g dash x equal to f x I minus f x I minus 1 by x I minus x I minus 1. So, the equation of the second line can be given by, so we know that thing, it can be given by x I plus 1 minus f x I by x I plus 1 minus x I. So, this is equal to g dash x I, and then we can write the solution of this equation. So, in this case our f x I plus 1, as it is intersecting this line, so this will be equal to 0. So, now we can solve this equation. So, by solving this equation we can write our x I plus 1 will be equal to x I minus f x I by g dash x I. So, we can apply this equation repeatedly to find a solution which is closer to this equation. So, that thing can be obtained by checking this x I plus 1 minus x I, the norm of this thing should be less than this, or this functional value, that is f x I plus 1 should be less than equal to epsilon 2. So, we will continue to find this x I plus 1 till these objective is achieved, that is it should converge, the solution should converge to a value, or it should be and the functional value should be closer to the 0. So, the functional value, that is f x, should be closer to 0, or this xi plus 1 minus xi should be very very small. So, either this or this, one can take either this criteria or this criteria, or one can take both the criteria to check the convergence. Also, so now we have seen four methods, that is method of bisection. So, in which the accurate point we are obtained, or the iteration point C we have obtained by making the section, by making the bisection, or taking initially taking two points and dividing that thing. So, we obtain this C value. And in case of regular falsification, so we have taken these points, joined them by a straight line, and then we obtain this false position C. After getting the false position, we check whether the solution is converged or not, or again we can take so that value, that C, as the next point, and then by taking this A, B and C, again we can join these two by another straight line and see where it is intersecting the x axis, then that C dash point or D point we can obtain, and this point we can iterate till we obtain the result. So, in case of Newton's method, so here we found the approximate solution x I plus 1 by using this equation. So, here we have to find the derivative of the point. Initially we take a point x I, then find the derivative of this function at that point, and after finding the functional value and its derivative, we can obtain the next point. And then we have used the second method. In case of second method, we require two points to fit a straight line. So, we approximate the straight line and we obtain the solution, or we obtain the closer approximation or approximate value by taking the slope of this line and the functional value at ith iteration. So, here we have to take two points, one x I minus 1, other one is x I, then find the functional value at x I and then the slope. To find the slope, we can use this information about these two points. Then after finding the slope at x I and the functional value at x I and taking the previous value x I, then we can obtain the x I plus 1. So, we can take one more method, so that is by Muller method. So, in case of Muller method, so instead of taking the straight line, so we can fit a curve, quadratic curve. So, by fitting a quadratic curve, so and using the similar procedure what we have used in case of this Newton's method and the second method, we can find the solution. Let this is the equation, or this is our function f x. Now, we will take a quadratic curve. So, this quadratic curve will intersect this our function at three position. So, we will obtain these three position. So, these three position, let us. So, we have approximated this line our f x by using this g x, and this g x can be, now it can be fitted by this quadratic polynomial. So, one can write this g x equal to a x minus x I. So, we have taken three points, one is x I, then this is our x I, this point is x I minus 1, or three points we have taken, this is x I minus 1 and this is x I minus 2. So, this g x can be written by using this formula, a into x I whole square plus b into x minus I plus c. So, as we have three points, then we can obtain this a, b and c, and after obtaining this value g x, then we can proceed in a similar way as we did in case of the Newton's method or second method to find this closure solution. That is, we can write this x I plus 1 equal to x I minus to C by B plus minus root over B square minus 4AC. So, the next iterative point one can obtain by using this expression, that is x I plus 1 equal to x I minus 2 c by root over b plus root over b square minus 4 a c, where a, b, c are can be obtained by solving this equation from these points. So, from these known points we have taken initially, we have selected 3 points x I, x I minus 1 and x I minus 2. And so, at these 3 points we know the functional value. So, after knowing this functional value, so we can fit this polynomial g x, and from this g x, as we know this functional value, we can solve these 3 equations to get a, b, c. And then, so from this we can find at which this becomes 0. So, this x I plus 1, by putting this g x equal to 0, so we can find this x I plus 1. So, x I plus 1 can be obtained from this equation, that is x I plus 1 equal to x I minus 2 c by root over 2 c by b plus minus root over b square minus 4 a c. So, a detailed of these methods one can find from this book by J D Hoffman, Numerical Methods for Engineer and Scientist, CRC Press. So, in this way, by using these numerical techniques, one can find the roots of these equations. So, these are for when we have a single equation f x. So, in case we have a set of equations, so when we have a set of equation, in that case, in case of a set of equation, let us see a set of equation. So, we can use this Newton's method effectively to find the solution. So, for example, let us, we have 2 equation, that is f x y equal to 0 and then g x y equal to 0. So, we have to, for example, let us take 2 equations. So, in this case, this is x and y. So, we have 2 function, that is f x y equal to 0, g x y equal to 0. So, given these 2 functions, our objective is to find x equal to x star and y equal to y star, for which, so for which we will have this f x star y star will be equal to 0, and similarly g x star y star will be equal to 0. So, for example, let us take, so let us see 2 equation. So, this is 1. So, let this is our f x, f x y equal to 0, this is also f, this represent f x y equal to 0. Similarly, let us take another equation, this is g x y equal to 0, and let this is also g x y equal to 0. So, this f x y equal to 0 curve separate this plane, that is x y plane, into 2 region, that is for which, for example, in this case, so this region in this f x y less than 0. So, outside of this thing f x y greater than 0. Similarly, here I can write this f x y less than 0. Similarly, for g one can write, this is g x y less than 0, and this side it is g x y greater than 0. Similarly, I can write here g x y greater than 0, outside it may be g x y less than 0. So, we have to find these points, this is one point, this is the second point, this is the third point in this particular case. So, at these points, so let me extend this thing and extend, so this is also one point. So, we have these 4 points, 1, 2, 3, 4. So, here we have seen, so we have 4 solutions for which, so we can, or we have to find 4 sets of solution for which this f x y will be equal to 0 and g x y will be equal to 0. So, to find the solution, so as we have discussed in case of method of bisection, so method of bisection, method of this regular falsi will not be suitable, and one can extend the Newton's method in this case to find the solution. So, here to find the solution, we can write this f x y, we can write our f. So, we can expand this x star y star equal to f I plus f x, or let me write simple f x I into x star minus x I plus f y I, so y star minus y I. Similarly, I can write this g x star and y star, expand this using this Taylor series by this. So, it will be g I plus g x I. So, this will be x star minus x I plus f y I y star minus y I. So, I have taken only one term. So, this is equal to, as this f x star y star equal to 0 and g x star y star equal to 0, our objective is to make this 0. So, from this we can write, so this equation can be written, we can write now this f x I. So, let me write this as delta x I. So, I can write this as delta x I plus f y at I delta y I. So, this will be equal to minus f I. Similarly, I can write this g x I delta x I plus g y I delta y I. So, this will be equal to minus g I. So, where this delta x I, this is delta x I and this is delta y I, this and this are delta y I. So, one can write these two equations in this form, or in matrix form one can write also this equation in this way. So, this will be equal to del f by del x, del f by del y. Similarly, this is del g by del x and del g by del y into delta x I delta y I. So, this will be equal to minus f I and g I. So, taking an initial condition x I, so one can obtain this f I g I, and also one can obtain this matrix, this is known as the Jacobian matrix. So, one can obtain this Jacobian matrix J, which is the matrix of the first derivative, and then one can obtain this delta x I and delta y I from this equation. So, after getting this delta x I and delta y I, one can write this x I plus 1 equal to x I plus delta x I. Similarly, y I plus 1 will be equal to y I plus delta y I. So, for two equations one can obtain the next iteration value numerically by using this x I and delta x I, y I and delta y I by using this formula. But to find this Jacobian matrix, sometimes it is required to numerically differentiate this equation, numerically differentiate the equation to find the differential. And after finding this Jacobian matrix, one can find the solution. So, let us take an n degree of freedom, n degree of freedom system. So, in case of n degree of freedom system, so one can write the general equation in this form, that is f x equal to 0, f x equal to 0. So, where one has to find this x value, so x may be, so x is a x 1, x 2, x 3 vector, x is the vector. So, f x equal to 0, we have to find. So, by solving, let our original differential, so we have to solve this equation system, we have a system of equation f x equal to 0, and we have to solve this equation to find this x 1, x 2, x 3 and all the roots. To do that thing, so this is x 1, x 2, x 3. So, to obtain, we can follow the similar procedure as we have discussed in case of this two equations. So, in this case we have to find this f x y equal to 0, so g x y. So, these two equations we have taken. So, instead of two equation, if we have more equation, we can follow the similar procedure. So, now we can find this, we can find this j delta equal to f. So, where j is the Jacobian matrix. So, this Jacobian matrix we can find this way. So, this will be equal to del f 1 by del x 1, del f1 by del x2, where this f can be written. So, we are writing, so this way this f is nothing but our f1, f2, fn. So, if this f equal to f1, f2, fn, then this Jacobian matrix can be found in this way, that is del f1 by del x1, del f1 by del x2, and del f1 by del xn, and proceeding similarly. So, we can have del f n by del x1, del f n by del x2, and finally, del f n by del x n. So, after getting this Jacobian matrix, now by solving this equation Jacobian matrix into delta x equal to f. So, from this we can find this delta x, and after getting this delta x, our next iteration, that is x I plus 1, will be equal to, so x I plus 1 will be equal to x I plus del x I. So, in this way we can find the roots if we have a set of equations present in this case. So, after finding these characteristic equations, so now our next step is to find the, so numerically integrate. So, after finding this characteristic equation, then we can substitute this beta l value in this equation to find the shape functions. So, this beta value, by putting this beta value, we can obtain the shape functions. So, after obtaining the shape functions, now our objective is to integrate this. So, one can use different numerical integration methods to find the integration. For example, one can use the Simpson rule or this trapezoidal rule to find the integration of this, to integrate these functions. After integrating, so one can obtain these coefficients, and after obtaining these coefficients, now after obtaining these coefficients, one can solve these equations either by perturbation method or by using this numerical solution method. To solve this numerical solution method, one may use this Runge-Kutta method. So, this, let us see this Runge-Kutta method, or one may use other numerical solution schemes. For example, one can use this finite difference method, Runge-Kutta method, this Hobolt method, Wilson method, and Neumark method. So, these methods can be used to obtain the numerical solution of this equation. So, one can solve these equations numerically to find this thing. So, let us discuss about this Runge-Kutta method to obtain the solution of the system. So, in case of Runge-Kutta method, so this fourth or fifth order Runge-Kutta method, first we have to write the governing equation using a set of first order differential equation. So, if we have equation, let we have a equation in this form, x at x double dot plus f x equal to 0. So, where this x can be written, let us take only two terms, x 1 and x 2. So, our equation, the first equation is x 1 dot plus f x 1 x 2 equal to 0, then second equation x 2 dot equal to f x 1 x 2 equal to 0. So, we can have a set of equation. So, in these equations, now our objective is to find the solution. So, to find that thing, first we have to write this equation using a set of first order equation. So, to write the set of first order equation, so first we can assume let x 1 dot equal to x 2, then this x 2 dot, which is equal to x double dot, we can write equal to, okay. So, one can write this equal to minus, in this case let me put this equation in this form, minus this thing, then it will be this plus. So, f x 1 x 2 t. So, now we have reduced this set of second order equation to a set of first order equation. So, after getting the set of first order equation and taking an initial condition x I, then this I plus 1 can be obtained by using this method. So, in this case, so this x I plus 1 can be obtained from this ith iteration. So, that is x I equal to 1 by x I plus 1 equal to x I plus 1 by 6 into k 1 plus 2 k 2 plus 2 k 3 plus k 4, where this k 1, k 2, k 3, k 4 are obtained by using this equation. So, where k 1 equal to h f x I t I, k 2 equal to h, so h is the increment we are taking here. So, k 2 equal to h into f. So, here the function are evaluated at a point at x I plus half k 1 and t I time equal to t I plus half h. Similarly, k 3 is evaluated at this point, that is x I plus half k 2, and here the time equal to t I plus half h, and k 4 is obtained from by using this expression, where the x is taken as x I plus k 3 and time t equal to t I plus 1. So, by evaluating this constant k 1, k 2, k 3, k 4 and substituting in this expression, so we can obtain this I plus 1th iteration value. And in this way, we can go on finding the value of x I plus 1 numerically till we converge to a solution. So, for example, let us take this doping Van der Pol equation. So, in case of the Van der Pol equation, so the obtained result, the time response is obtained like this. So, this is the phase portrait obtained, time response phase portrait, and one can obtain the spectra also, power spectra also one can obtain. So, in this way, by using this RK4 method, one can find the time response of the system. So, today class we have studied how to find the roots of the characteristic equation by using different numerical techniques. So, these numerical techniques include method of bisection, regular Falsi method, Newton's method, second method and Muller's method, and then we have studied how to find this integration of numerical integration to find the coefficients after getting this equation or after getting this temporal equation. Now, we know there are several numerical methods available, but we have studied this Runge-Kutta method to find the solution of the system. So, in this way we can find the time response of the system. So, next class we will discuss how to characterize this time response what we have obtained, then we will discuss about the frequency response of the system, and then we will study about how to obtain the basin of attraction when there are multiple solutions exist in a system. So, one can take some exercise problem or one can solve. So, take this exercise problem of, so solve this doping equation using Runge-Kutta method, that is solve this equation x double dot plus x plus alpha x q equal to f cos omega t. Take different value of this alpha, and let us add this damping also, 2 mu x dot. So, let us take this alpha equal to 0.3, mu equal to 0.05 and f equal to 0.5 and omega equal to 1. So, taking this use RK4 method to find Runge-Kutta, fourth order Runge-Kutta method to find the solution of this equation. And so, in MATLAB one can easily solve this equation by using the function OD45, inbuilt function in the MATLAB. So, next class we will study or we will find or we will characterize this time response what we have observed, and we will show the solution of this equation also. Thank you.